What is up, guys? Hero of Wisdom here. Spider-Man 2 has released to various opinions and controversy, but hear me when I tell you that those opinions don't matter. Only mine does. Okay. Personally, I greatly enjoyed the game, and this probably won't be the last video on it, but I couldn't help but notice all the Easter eggs that Insomniac littered throughout. I wanted to point out some of my favorites. Now, if you do end up enjoying this video, a subscription is always appreciated, and if I miss something, or if you think one of my references is a stretch, let me know in the comments below. And by the way, if it wasn't obvious, ginormous spoilers ahead. Venom kills Kraven! With that being said, let's get into it. This is probably one of the biggest assumptions, biggest stretches made in the entire history of top 10 videos, let alone YouTube videos as a whole. In the flashback mission where you go back to Peter Parker's high school and play as a scrawny, younger Peter Parker, it takes place during Homecoming.
Pause. This might be a stretch, but I think that's the Doctor Strange logo right there. All right, back to the video.
Spider-Man, Homecoming, Spider-Man Homecoming. Lock in. In the Coney Island mission, a bunch of civilians can be seen with a shirt that has a Spider-Man mask in the shape of a heart. This is, of course, the shirt that Mary Jane is often seen wearing in the comics. That's it. That's the whole Easter egg. This is a Spider-Man game, but with the Fantastic Four's tower being built, the Sanctum Sanctorum being a major plot point with Wong and the Doctor being name-dropped, and of course the tallest building in the game being Avengers Tower, it's obvious that other superheroes exist in this reality besides Spider-Man and his amazing friends. But throughout the city, you can see this Captain America Frisbee being tossed. Clearly, Spider-Man isn't the only one that gets merchandise around here. I'm genuinely hoping that after Spider-Man has had its run for a while, we'll get some games based on other superheroes made by Insomniac. They could probably make a better Avengers game than what we have. Ugh, gross. Ew. This one might also be a stretch, but I think it's true, and I'm proud that I pointed this out. In the same Homecoming mission, there's these posters of a dinosaur working a turntable. Now, I think that this is either a reference to Devil Dinosaur or Reptil. No one talks about this guy anymore, but he's pretty cool. He's an original character from the work of art that was Superhero Squad, and he also has the green and orangish-reddish color scheme. More likely, though, this isn't a reference at all, and is just a funky design to put on a poster. When you're cleaning out Aunt May's house, you can see that Peter Parker has a copy of the video game Speed Nonagon. This is the game that Genki was working on for practically the entirety of Spider-Man Miles Morales. I think it's really sweet that he actually published it, and not only published it, but gave Peter a copy. I couldn't find it, but I know that somewhere in Spider-Man 2, there's a line about him developing Speed Nonagon 2. I know I heard it, but I really don't feel like finding it. Low key, high key. In Peter's old bedroom in Aunt May's house, you can see this poster for a wrestling match. This, of course, being a reference to Peter Parker's amateur wrestling days before he became the web-slinging superhero we know today.
What's your name, kid?
The Human Spider.
The Human Spider, that's it? That's the best you got?
Yeah.
Oh, that sucks.
And if you look especially closely, you can see that that mask is from the same suit that you can play as based on the same event in the first game. And honestly, I'm hoping we get more flashback missions in any future projects like we did in this game. I would love to play as a wrestler Peter Parker. almost the entirety of Coney Island references different Marvel characters. I mean, obviously, mostly Spider-Man characters, but Marvel characters. But the most noticeable is Speed Demon, the ride that they're talking about the entire time. I mean, his character is in front of the ride, and there's cardboard cutouts all over, and his little mini character is on the map. If you don't know, Speed Demon is sort of a niche Spider-Man villain who, believe it or not, has the power of super speed. Another one of these references to a Spider-Man villain is this octopus has a doctor outfit on. Do I need to make that connection for you? Y'all are probably smart. I think you can figure it out. Probably the most recognizable and iconic piece of Spider-Man media after Across the Spider-Verse and just after it's been getting more attention. After you do a team-up mission with Spider-Man and other Spider-Man, you can do this little emote where they point at each other, just like in the classic cartoon. So two times in this game, we get a look at Peter Parker's first ever front cover for the Daily Bugle. Eagle-eyed fans will notice that this is clearly a reference to the first cover of Spider-Man number 1 from 1962. You can see it on the bulletin board just as Peter Parker is taking it off to reveal the hole in the wall before the lesson about balance from Aunt May beyond the grave, but also in a mission where this civilian wants to take a good picture of Spider-Man. You get a much better look at it there, and then get to play an entire mission where Peter is working to give the picture to Jonah. All right, here's an honorable mention before number 1, which you're gonna wanna stick around for. In the mission where you get to play as Haley and go around fixing the graffiti on the walls, this cat has a Spider-Man plushie.
Spider plushie!
Number 1, the glue. None of you are gonna know what I'm talking about when I say that. I haven't seen anyone talking about this, and I swear, if someone has, please let me know, but as far as I know, I'm the only person to see this. I think there's this bottle of glue on Peter's old desk in Aunt May's house with some text on the back. What I'm about to read to you is my best transcription of what it says, and you can read along. I think I only missed about 3 words, but here's what it says. Danger. Don't do dumb things that'll get you dead. Don't glue this to a child. Don't give this to a man-child. Do smart things. Here's some instructional text and some more text with a little bit more text, but absolutely no substance. This means nothing. You might think it's a hidden statement of how empty words can possibly be. I mean, this is just noise, as noise might work. Shapes and colors make images, but really the space just needs to be filled. If you've somehow managed to read this, yo, rad, good job. How's your day? Good, I hope. Remember, you can achieve anything. Follow your dreams in, like, a smart way. If you believe you can fly, don't go jumping off buildings thinking you'll grow wings or some stuff like that. Can we use swear words and text in a rated T game? You'll diversify your language. Just don't... I don't know this part. It, you know? All right, I think we've done it. You've got better things to do, bucko. Enjoy your day. I haven't seen anyone talking about that. That's hilarious. Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. There will be more videos on Spider-Man 2, most likely, because I have more to talk about. I'm a bit of a professional yapper, if you couldn't already tell by watching this video. If any of you can figure out those few words I couldn't see on the glue bottle, please let me know. My Instagram and my TikTok are at the end of this video. Not trying to shameless plug. I literally need you to contact me if you can figure it out. It's in the flashback level. It's in Aunt May's house on Peter Parker's desk. Please find it. And if you post about it, please give me credit. I'm so proud of myself, unless I'm not the first to find this, which probably not. Thank you all for watching. I'm the Hero of Wisdom, and I will see you all next time. Peace out.